Very good morning, everybody. I am very happy to participate in the convocation of Jawaharlal Nehru Architecture and Finance University. It's a pleasure to be among the bright, young, creative minds in the Telangana state. I am very happy to know that this university is a specialized university which focuses only on creative programs related to built environment and fine arts, which include not only the traditional departments like architecture, urban planning and painting, but also new ones such as animation, interior design and facility planning. In this sense, it is a unique university. First of all, I congratulate the Vice Chancellor, Madam Kavita, for her extraordinary performance in this field. When I convened the Vice Chancellor's meet, immediately when I acquired the position of the Governor of Telangana, that is Chancellor of Universities, when I convened the meeting of the Chancellor, Vice Chancellors, I really impressed by the way she presented about her university in that conference. I could feel the drive in her to make this specialty to the topmost specialty, and her drive to make the students to top themselves in this field. Really, I appreciate her drive. And my respects to all the dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, and I should congratulate the Padmashri Dr. Kalal Lakshmagau for his exemplary work in this field. As he told, it took 5 decades for him to acquire this position, and during these 5 decades, his work on this field is highly appreciable. And apart from that, I appreciate the presentation of Sri Habib Khan, the President, Council of Architecture, for his convocation address. And I should say, as students, you have assembled here, and I should appreciate this convocation is conducted after quite a longer time. And I feel that each and every year, these students should celebrate this day of convocation, and that is my wish, and it will be really conducted. That is my belief. Apart from that, today's students passing out in this college face up many challenges. It is a different field. It's a field of innovation and imagination. First of all, I congratulate all the degree holders, masters as well as the bachelor degree holders and the gold medal winners. As I said, this is a university with unique features. Your participation is needed in the day-to-day life. Apart from that, I should say, as Madam Vice Chancellor here mentioned today, I noticed in the media that the cheap furniture setup, which is in the creative minds of this university, the state government has asked this university to contribute for this furniture setup, which I congratulate the university for this unique experience and your innovative procedures. First thing I should learn is that though you must have some long-term objectives, you should keep yourself ready for change. So whatever may be the convocation address, I take a point for the young students, each convocation, each topic. Today, I want you to be prepared. Today, the message I want to convey to you is be prepared. Be prepared to face the challenges. Be prepared to use the opportunities. That is the main challenge which we face today. Be prepared, because when we are not prepared, even the challenges are rendered to you, even if we face with high opportunities, you cannot use that opportunity. And here, as it is said in the convocation address, even though we should study the architecture, which is very prevalent and which is very prevalent in the abroad, I want to say that, first of all, my appeal is study the ancient architecture of our great India. So I want to say that I come from the state of Tamil Nadu. We have so much of architectural buildings, particularly the temples. For example, Tanjavur, I am the student of the Tanjavur Medical College, and Tanjavur, the big temple we have. It was constructed with a single stone, and even we cannot see the shadows even today. That is a great architecture which was prevalent even 1,000 years ago before in our country. And I should say, I congratulate our Honorable Prime Minister when he planned the visit of our Honorable President of China to be in the highest architectural pride of Tamil Nadu as well as India, that is the Mahabalipuram. The architecture, the stone architecture in Mahabalipuram is really highly fantastic architecture, and I believe that after our Prime Minister's visit and after our Prime Minister's meeting with the Honorable President of China, there is a great fascination to visit that place, to conduct marriages in that place, to conduct programs in that place, and I should say there is an appeal of visa. More than 2 lakh Chinese have appealed for visa to visit Mahabalipuram. That is the attraction of our architecture. So as students of architecture, you should have, even though the new innovative mind, to innovate new ideas. And my appeal is, you have to study the ancient architecture of our country. And apart from that, as students of art, you are the Brahmas, because you create things. You are the Brahmas of this field. And I should say in Ramayana, that is Kambar Ramayana, Kambar explains Rama's face as the face looks like an arch of lotus. So when the literary people, when the Star Wars are in that field, in the court, when they ask, why you are explaining the face of Rama as the arch of lotus, as a paint of lotus. So he said, Kambar said, who wrote Ramayana in Tamil, he said, I cannot imagine Rama's face to be fade away, droop away. So his face will be fresh as a painting of the lotus as ever. Because real lotus may fade away, may droop away, but the painting of the lotus will be ever fresh. So I want the Rama's face to be like that. So that is the beauty of the art. That is the beauty of the imagination. So I appeal each and everyone, as I said, be prepared, because there are many challenges. The world is moving very fast, and we, due to innovation of so many technologies, which is really a challenge. Before and all, we can see the art in the reception halls, and we can see the art in most of the places. But now the paintings are replaced by some of the printers and some of the printings and some of the artificial methods. So each and every day we are facing with challenges. And the new branch of artificial intelligence also emerging in. So we have to face all the challenges. It's not the field as it was faced by our Honorable Lakshman Gowd. Really, the students are facing much of the challenges. And apart from that, I should say, you should learn about the beautiful architecture of our country, whether religious, non-religious places. And I should say, in Chennai, near the beach, there is a statue of Munro. That is the beautiful example of architecture. But why I am saying that you all should face the challenges, I read in a paper, in a media, that Munro statue had some mistake. It was done without the saddle. And when it was pointed out, I believe that was a very beautiful monument of architecture. And when it was pointed out, the architect who made it said that it was done voluntarily because it should be noticed by others. But even when it was criticized, I believe he committed suicide. So I want to say that whatever may be the challenges, there we may face some criticism. We may appreciate our art, work of art, but we may face so much of challenges. But the youngsters in this field, not only in this field, the youngsters of this era, this century, should be courageous enough to face what all the challenges they face in the field which they are gaining their degree and postmaster degree. Why I am telling this? Because nowadays the children are going into depression in a much easier way than the previous generation. So you have to have a much courageous mind to face the generation, and now we have to search for job opportunities. The opportunities, you should gain the opportunity and you should face and you should get the opportunity when it is rendered to you. For example, you should use the opportunity whenever you come across the challenges. You should not wait for the opportunities. For example, I should say there was an interview for a marketing person. Two marketing persons went for the interview. In one of them, to them, the CEO of the company told that you have to go to an island for the sale of the shoes, which is introduced by our company. So both of them went there and they went to assess the market. Both of them returned. One told, sir, there is no any opportunity for the sale of the shoes in that island. Other said, there is ample opportunity for the sale of the shoes in that island. Then the CEO asked, both of them went to the same island and both of them monitored and assessed the marketing opportunities in that island. But one is saying that there is ample opportunity and one is saying there is no opportunity. What's the matter? He asked. Then both of them told the tribals in that island don't have the habit of wearing the shoes. So one of the optimistic person viewed it as an opportunity. So these people don't have the opportunity, don't have the habit of wearing the shoes. So it's an ample opportunity to market the shoes so that we can practice them to wear the shoes. The other one, a pessimistic one, viewed it as there is no any opportunity. So he came and told, there is no any opportunity of sale of the shoes because they don't have the habit of wearing the shoes. So I request the young minds, you should use whatever may be the opportunities come across you. Particularly, this is an innovative field. This innovative imagination, the imagination, for example, the architecture is moving forward in each and every day in a much different way. For example, in a railway station which is situated in the city of Tokyo, Japan, there noticed a large number of suicides. Particularly the students and particularly the depressed people came to the station and they jumped into the track and they committed suicide. Then all the eminent people analyzed the place. They found out there was a red light in that area that motivated the depression. They motivated it, increased the heart rate, and they replaced it with a blue light. That is the architecture, that's the art of color. They replaced it with a blue light. Why they use the blue light means they learned that the blue color decreases the depression and improves the mood elevation And they replace all the bulbs of the lights of the station with the blue bulbs. The students came there, they become very calm, and it was found within 1 year, 70% of suicide reduced in that area. So that is the beauty of color, that is the beauty of architecture, and that is the beauty of art, and that is the beauty of innovation, and that is the beauty of imagination. So I appeal to apply the mind. Whenever we face the challenges, apply the mind, and I appeal to you, be prepared for anything. Be prepared to face the challenges, to be prepared to use the opportunities, and be prepared. I wish all the young talent heads of Telangana all the best. Really, I am also a lover of art. Even though I am the governor, I am a doctor, I used to do paintings, and I am lover of art, and as a co-lover of art, I appreciate you all for choosing this specialty as your primary specialty. I don't know whether you like or you are forced to take this specialty, but now you have acquired the degree of this field. I am telling the Honorable President, former President, Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, he has said in one of his interviews, I want to become a different person, but I learned philosophy because of my poor economical conditions, I had free books from one of my relatives in philosophy. So I selected philosophy, and later he wrote large number of books on philosophy. So whatever may be the field, we should like the field, we should do extraordinary efforts in the field, and we should top the field. And I really congratulate all your efforts. As a co-person, an artist, because I love painting, I love art, and love architecture. And another appeal is, when you apply architecture, don't concentrate only on beauty. Please concentrate on safety also. Because nowadays, architecture, we concentrate on the beauty, and sometimes we don't concentrate on the safety. So when a beautiful architecture, if a beautiful architecture is applied in the hospital structure, it will facilitate good treatment. And if good architecture is applied in the building of schools, it will facilitate good education. And if good architecture is applied in the building of industry, it will facilitate good workout. So whatever may be the architecture, good architecture is for improvement, and I congratulate each and everyone who has acquired the degree today. Thank you so much.